ब्रह्मनाथ। शांति 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 ही स्वस्थ।
गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द सेकेंड यूनिट ऑफ अ लेजेंड बिहाइंड अ लेजेंड बाय हरिहरन बालकृष्ण। बिफोर वी गो टू द सेकेंड यूनिट, लेट्स जस्ट क्विकली रिकैपिटुलेट द फर्स्ट यूनिट। In the first unit, we gathered that the author Hariharan Balakrishnan came across a small news item in the Statesman, the newspaper. Being excited and curious to meet Khairi, the tigress who had made the Sidilipal forest famous with her presence and grace, and Mr. Saroj Raj Chaudhary, he did query about Saroj Raj Chaudhary to a senior journalist, Mr. N.S. Iyengar, and few elderly people. And he gathered the information that he gathered about Mr. Chaudhary, the forest officer, that he was a very hard-hearted person or a harsh person who was rough, and he did not tolerate any stupidity or foolishness. Rather, he only tolerated important and necessary things. Then finally, the author Hariharan Balakrishnan did write a letter to Mr. Chaudhary, as he was curious to go and meet Khairi and him. The author also mentioned in the letter about his itinerant articles that he had published in the Indian magazine, and that was a hopeful attempt or a shot in the dark. Finally, the response was positive from Mr. Saroj Raj Chaudhary's side, and the author was invited to Khairi Jashipur. Not only invited, he was also being asked by Mr. Chaudhary to mention the date and time and how he would reach Jashipur. So now let's get to Unit 2. I packed my bag. I here refers to the author, writer Hariharan Balakrishnan. Took the train and boarded the overcrowded bus from Bhubaneswar. So as being invited by Mr. Chaudhary, the author, who was so curious, so excited to go and meet Mr. Chaudhary and Khairi, packed his bags. And what did he do? He took the train and boarded the overcrowded bus. The bus was heavily crowded with people. He boarded the bus from Bhubaneswar. I arrived sometime before 4 a.m., wondering where to go in that semi-darkness. So the author reached Jashipur. He reached there around 4 a.m. 4 a.m. means before the dawn, before dawn, okay? D-A-W-N, dawn. So before dawn. And he was wondering. Wondering means showing curiosity. He was curious now, as he had reached in the semi-darkness, when there was neither light and it was dark. And so he was curious, he was wondering, he was showing the curiosity where to go now. To my utter surprise, within a minute, surprise means completely surprised. Within a minute, there was a click of boots and a voice welcoming me to Kylie Jashipur. Click here refers to the sound of the boots. Okay, when one walks or climbs staircases wearing boots, the sound of the boots. And he heard the sound of the boots and a man welcoming him. Him means the man who had arrived there welcomed the author to Kairi Jashipur. The forest guard detained to escort me. Escort here refers to guide. Okay? Escort means to guide. Took me to the guest house. Put me in my room. Assured means to make others sure, okay, that water was in the jug. So who had arrived there? Whose sound of the boots did the author writer Hariharan hear? He heard. Who was there? The forest guard. The forest guard had reached there at the spot to welcome the author Hariharan, and he welcomed him, guided him, and took him to the guest house. He made him feel comfortable in his room. A room was allotted to the author writer Hariharan Balakrishnan, and he made him comfortable in that room. And he also made him sure that water was in the jar. Assured means to make someone sure, to make others sure. So made him sure that water was in the jar. And who did all this? The forest guard, who was sent to guide and escort Miss the author, writer Hariharan Balakrishnan to the guest house. I could sleep as long as I wanted. And Mr. Chaudhry or Mr. Saroj Raj Chaudhry, and the forest guard did quote Mr. Saroj Raj Chaudhry as Sir. So what did he say? I could sleep as long as I wanted, and Sir would see me as soon as I was ready. So as he had reached, as the author Hariharan had reached at 4 a.m. in semi-darkness, he was escorted, he was guided by a forest guard to a guest house, and he was made comfortable in a room. And the guard also assured him, made him sure that water was there in the jug. You could have a nice sleep, you could go to sleep, complete your sleep, and when I wanted you, I refers to the author. Writer Hariharan Balakrishnan. So he was assured by the forest guard who had guided him and escorted him, who had been there to welcome him. He did say that you could take your long sleep, comfortable sleep, and as soon as you would get ready, Mr. Saroj Raj Chaudhry would see you, or you would meet Mr. Saroj Raj Chaudhry. So what did we get here? That as soon as the author writer Hariharan, he was invited by Mr. Saroj Raj Chaudhry, packed his bags. He took the train and boarded the crowded bus from Bhubaneswar. He reached around 4 a.m. and it was semi-dark. So he was completely curious where to go. Finally, he heard the sound of the boots, or the click of the boots, and the forest guard was there to welcome him, guide him, and take him to the guest house where a room was arranged for him. The forest guard made him comfortable in the room and assured him, or made him sure, that water was there in the jug. He could sleep, and then when he would get up and get ready, he would go and meet his sir or Mr. Saroj Raj Chaudhry. So the second paragraph. I think I had an hour of blissful sleep. Okay? Here blissful can mean delightful sleep. Delightful. Clear? with a shock. Why did he get up with a shock? Because he heard the voice of the tiger just outside the door. I was terror struck. Terror struck means frightened. The writer was frightened. When it happened, he had a delightful sleep, and the moment he heard the voice of the tiger roaring outside the door of the guest house, he just got frightened. He was shocked and he got up. I was terror struck. Terror struck means frightened. Within minutes, a bear came to the room with hot tea and biscuits. So here, bear means one who carries, okay, things, is known as a bear. So a bear came to the room with hot tea and biscuits for the author, who was now ready. He smiled at the expression on my face and assured me that it was only carry outside the door. As the expression of the author, writer, wasn't a normal one. He was in a delightful sleep. He was enjoying his sleep and he just got up with a shock. A shock because he heard the voice of a tiger roaring outside the door of the guest house. So he was frightened, and the expression was that there was an impression on the face of the writer that he was scared, very scared and frightened now. And when the bearer who came with hot tea and biscuits did see the expression on the face of the writer, author Hariharan Bal Krishnan, he smiled and made him feel easy by saying that, "Don't worry, it's just the tiger." And making friendly inquiries, the tiger is making friendly inquiries about the new guest in the house. See, he smiled at the expression on my face and assured me, gave assurance or made him sure. The bearer made Hariharan sure that don't get scared, don't get frightened, nothing is going to happen. Because that it was only carry outside the door. It was carry the tigress, the domesticated tigress who had made the Simlipal forest so famous with her presence. It was she who was trying to find out with a friendly gesture. She was trying to inquire. What was she trying to inquire? About the new guest in the house. The new guest in the guest house. And who was the new guest? The author, writer, Hariharan Balakrishnan. I finished my tea, had a quick shower, and went to the main house. So now when the bearer made him comfortable, made the writer, author comfortable and easy, he did have his tea. Then he had a quick shower. Shower means to take bath. We do not say, you know, nowadays in a bias-free way, we don't say, "I'll take my bath." We say that, "I'll have my shower now. I'll go for my shower now." So, shower means to take bath. And went to the main house. Now, the author, Hariharan, got ready now to go and meet Mr. Saroj Raj Chaudhary. So, let's come to the third paragraph. Saroj Raj Chaudhary was sitting on a large chair when, after completion of tea and biscuits and then having a shower or a bath, Mr. Hariharan or the author, writer got ready to go to the main house so that he could meet the forest officer, Mr. Saroj Raj Chaudhary. And when he went there, what did he see? What was Mr. Chaudhary doing? He was sitting on a large chair and there was a sloth bear behind him holding onto his vest and making gurgling sounds. So what was he doing? Saroj Raj Chaudhary was sitting on a large chair. And who was there with Saroj Raj Chaudhary? A sloth bear. Sloth bear is actually a bear that is found in Indian subcontinent. Okay, it feeds on fruits, it feeds on ants and termites, and it is actually listed as vulnerable. Why? Because of loss of habitat. I repeat again, sloth bear. Clear? If you just take sloth as a single word, it means lazy here. But sloth bear refers actually to a bear which is found in the Indian subcontinent, and it feeds on fruits, ants and termites, and it's vulnerable because it has a loss of natural habitat. Is known as a sloth bear. So there was a sloth bear behind him, holding on to his waist and making gurgling sounds, the sounds that was produced by the bear. Mr. Saroj Das Chaudhary was seated on a large chair, and there was a bear, and the bear was holding the waist of Saroj Das Chaudhary and making the gurgling sounds. He said, "Get down, Jambu. Get down," and rose to greet me. So here, get down. Who's Jambu? The name of the bear, sloth bear. As we Christian, Christian means giving names. As Mr. Saroj Das Chaudhary had a collection of menagerie of, or a collection of wild animals, and so he also had a bear as an animal, as a pet at his home, and so he had named the bear, he had christened the bear as Jambu, and so he said, who said? Mr. Saroj Das Chaudhary said to the bear or Jambu to get down, and the past tense of rise is rose, and he rose, he got up to greet me. Me here refers to the author, writer Hariharan Balakrishnan, a frail man. We have come across this word in three, we have come across this word, and so this is frail. Frail here means weak and thin. In three questions, we have come across this word. So a frail man in his 50s. So when Saroj Das Chaudhary got up asking Jambu to get down, or the sloth bear to get down, when he rose up, he rise up, he got up from the large chair that he was comfortably sitting on. When he got up from there, he saw, what did the writer see? Or Hariharan see? And he saw that Mr. Saroj Das Chaudhary was a weak and thin man in his 50s. Slightly balding on the top. Slightly balding. Balding means when you have no head. Bald head, you know. Clean and clear head. That's called balding, or bald head. Slightly balding on the top. The top portion of the head was bald, or it was clean and polished. There was no hair on the top of the head. We got talking. We got talking means who got talking? Mr. Chaudhary and the author, writer Hariharan Balakrishnan, both of them, after meeting each other, after Mr. Saroj Das Chaudhary greeting him, and when Hariharan found that Mr. Chaudhary was a weak and thin person in his 50s with slightly bowling on the top, without hair on the top of his head. And both of them sat down, talking, exchanging their feelings, exchanging their discussion, their whatever their views they had, and they sat down talking. We got talking. I did not find it rough and rough, no nonsense man. So here, Hariharan discovered in Unit 1, we did gather about Mr. Chaudhary that he was being narrated, he was being told. He means who? The author was being told by N.S. Iyengar, a senior journalist in Barrampur, and some elders, that Mr. Chaudhary was a hard-hearted person who was harsh, who was rough, and he did not tolerate any nonsense. So here, after meeting Mr. Chaudhary, the writer, the discovered himself. He did come to know that. What did he come to know? That I being fine, gruff and rough, no nonsense man. That the man of Mr. Chaudhary was not at all a harsh or a hard-hearted person or a rough person. Okay? So as the impression given to the author Hariharan by the journalist, senior journalist and other elderly people, he found just the opposite. When he happened to meet, physically go close to Mr. Chaudhary and meet him by person, he saw that Mr. Chaudhary was not at all a hard-hearted person or a rough person. What I found was one of the most human beings I had ever met in my life. So what did he discover about Mr. Chaudhary? He means who? The author. What did the author Hariharan discover about Mr. Chaudhary? He saw that. He found out that Mr. Chaudhary was indeed a human. A human means a person very caring towards not only people but also towards animals, who was filled with kindness, with care, not only for people, for human beings, but also for animals, is known as human being. He was a perfect human being who was filled with or blended with kindness and care for not only people but also for animals. It just found out an opposite person of what he had heard and I had ever met in my life. He quotes, the author says, Hariharan says, that he had never met such a human being who was filled with so much of kindness and care prior to this. He had never met in his life. And so with this, we have completed Unit 2. We have discussed Unit 2. So before we wind up, let's just have two questions. And the first question is, what was the physical appearance of Mr. Chaudhary? The physical appearance of Mr. Chaudhary was that he was in his 50s and a weak and thin person with slightly balding on the top. Clear? A man who was in his 50s, who was weak and thin, or a frail man who was having slightly balding on the top. The second question, what kind of man did the author find Mr. Chaudhary to be? So what kind of man did the author? The author found that Mr. Chaudhary was a very kind and caring person, not only for people but also for animals. He was a perfect human being. He was not at all a hard-hearted person or a harsh or a grove person. So with this, we have completed Unit 2. In my next video, we will discuss Unit 3 of the legend behind the legend. Thank you.